is Maggie Rentala again, and we're back with Workout San Diego. Marie, I've had so much fun. I cannot believe what an incredibly hard workout this is. Tell us.
But doable, right? You guys, it was hard for everybody, but it was totally doable. And it's, this is where you're going to build your strength. So you don't need to be strong before you come here. You're going to build your strength here, right? I think everybody got strong a little bit. We'll stretch at the end too, but it's a workout. I discovered that when I took my first class, and that's why I had to open the studio. I just fell in love with it and had to bring it to more people.
I'm glad you did that. I'm really enjoying myself. Tell us, what is the pinnacle pole we're going
to
see?
The pinnacle of pole would be to climb up the pole, invert up in the air, and do crazy tricks up in the air. And there's lots of YouTube videos you can see, lots of people doing amazing things like that. You guys learned the basic climb earlier, then we'll climb it up higher eventually in your intermediate tricks class. Right now we're going to learn how to invert, and we're going to do it safely from the floor. We don't want people jumping into it standing up already. So we're going to lay down on the floor, get used to getting our feet up in the air. And we have a couple of ways to get you used to being upside down, and we'll work on those right now when you're ready.
Great. I'm looking forward to it. Workout San Diego, upside down.
Okay, so on your backs, all the way down. Scoot all the way down. Armpit. I know it's cold, but if you have a little bit of sticky skin touching the pole, it's going to help you invert. Left hand goes above, so you're holding the pole with a left-handed baseball bat. Lift your hips up in the air. That's the most important thing. If you don't get your hips up, you're not engaging the muscles. You need to be strong to invert. And if this is hard right now, that's great. That means you need to strengthen these muscles before you invert standing up. Push through your right heel so you can hook your left ankle on the pole in front of you. And get that ankle all the way on the pole. And you're going to use that ankle to pull your hips into the pole and put your right foot behind the pole. Hips go all the way to the pole, and then lengthen legs along the pole, and you're going to wrap your knees around the pole, kind of like we did when we were standing up, and stay right there. I'm going to come and help you. Don't move. Perfect. Good. Bringing this knee around just a bit. Oops, don't let go. Yeah, just bring it around so you've got nice, good, tight. This foot, keep the knee right where it is. This foot's going to go behind the pole. Wrap your knees in together. Good. Beautiful. Stay right where you're at. The next thing I'm going to have you do is from this position, crank your neck around so you can kind of see me. What I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you pull your hips up, bring your legs higher. Open your knees, grab higher, pull your hips in the air, bring your knees higher. It's okay if you slide down. Totally okay if you slide down in between.
Yeah, we should have read.
But I want you to pull that booty up, and then I'll grab towels.
Absolutely.
Good, pull that booty up. Perfect, Maggie. So if you're strong like Maggie, you might get off the floor. That's awesome. That's the goal eventually. You're going to tuck your chin to your chest, release your hands just a bit so you can slide down to the back onto your shoulder. Perfect. Legs down with control. Good. Nice. So they're in the way right now. When we get to the end of getting the full inversion, then we'll start getting them out of the way. Usually the first class you won't get your hands out of the way yet. Booty up. Perfect. Nice. Perfect. And then legs down with control. Yep, everybody legs down with control. Back to the floor, scoot down. We're going to do it all again from the beginning. Scoot down to the poles in your armpit. Right arm wraps, left hand is just above. Good. Hold the pole at the baseball bat. Hands in close, don't reach way up high. Have them in close to your chest. Lift your hips up into bridge. That's the most important. Get those hips up into bridge. Now from here, left ankle is going to hook on the pole in front of your face. Use that ankle hook to pull your hips into the pole. Other leg goes right leg goes behind the pole, and the pole's between your knees. Good, nice, perfect. Now open your knees just a bit, see if you can grab up between your knees and pull your booty up in the air. And that's it, Melissa, exactly, good. Perfect, do it again, and it's totally fine. If you're sliding, Paloma, that's totally fine. Just slide down and reach up and pull up again. Nice,
do it again.
And pull your booty up, here's your goal. Get your hands just a bit higher. Yeah, you lifted your booty. Yep, exactly. That's the goal. So you feel those muscles engaging that need to lift your booty up. That's what needs to be strong to invert standing up. Legs slide. You slide down the floor to the chest. Perfect. Everybody else, legs down with control. Back to the floor. Good. And let's do it again. So legs down to the floor, and let's do it again. Wrap your arms. You got your left-handed baseball bat. Your armpit is on the pole. Scoot down if you slid around and it's not in the pole. Hips up into bridge. And again, remember, hips up into bridge. If you want to get stronger and be able to do this, do work on this bridge, just like this. Left ankle hooks on the pole in front of your face. Wrap in. Yeah, so that you're holding the pole in tight. Right pull. Use that ankle to pull the right foot behind. Good. Close your knees over it, and then open your knees. Perfect, you fixed that, Melissa. Open your knees, pull your booty up. Yes, nice. And you've got it. It's totally fine that you're sliding. I can see you're lifting your booty. You're engaging the right muscles. Good. And then close your legs again whenever you're done climbing up. Good. Just to get used to pulling them in. Legs down with control. So I know your hands are kind of in the way, but without them, it would be impossible to hold yourself up there right now, so you just gonna have to deal with that. Once you get the more advanced version, then you'll be able to pull your hands out and your legs will stick more because your hands will be in the way. Okay, so next version is to do it seated. So watch me first. You can take a break while you watch. I'm wrapping my right arm by my head. My left hand is just above. Hips out into bridge, and my pull is in my armpit again. If I slid way down here, then it's hard. There's no room for my ankle. So my chest is right by my hands. Pull is in that armpit. I'm going to lift my hips up. I'm going to hook that left ankle. Right foot goes behind. Pull my hips into the pull. Extend the legs up the pull. Hang out for a bit, and then chin the chest. Let your hands slide down onto your shoulder. Legs down with control. Three things. You're going to tuck your chin to chest. I want that muscle memory to be natural to you. Anytime you start to fall, chin to chest. You don't want to land on your head or your face. Shoulder can support more weight. It's not going to get injured as bad as your spine would. Second thing is your hands need to be able to slide down the pole. Even if you feel like you're slippery now, once you get up there, you might have your hands sticking. So you need to get used to you being in control. Always slide fast, always slide slow, but you need to practice that slide. Make sure one hand doesn't go on top of the other. They're separated. And then third, most important thing, legs down with control. It's hard, but it builds strength and it'll prevent injury. And I want that muscle memory of control so that when you're doing my intermediate tricks class, you're not falling out of something. If I hear you land like that, you don't get to go to the next level. Okay, see you next to your pole. Wrap your right arm, left hand above. Hips way out in front of you, pole is in that armpit. Lift your hips up, hook your left ankle, right foot behind. Good. And then chin to chest. Good. You totally had it. You just psyched yourself out. Chin to chest. Slide down. Let your hands slide. Nice. Perfect. Let's do that again. Let's do it again. Ready?
Was I supposed to melt off of the
pole? You're perfect. You're perfect.
I felt like I was melting.
Sit next to your pole. Back right. Left hand is just above. Hips up in the air. So you're supposed to choose the left hand is high. Hips up. Left ankle's gonna hook on the pole. Right foot goes behind. Good, beautiful. And then chin your chest and slide down. Nice, perfect. So you've got it. Once you get there, see if you can pull your legs into the pole, your hips, into the pole and let your legs go. So yours right now is like this.
Okay.
You want this. That's your goal.
Come on.
Let's try again.
Yep, try again. And yours is perfect. I'm gonna take you to standing next. Perfect. And then slide down. You're just good. You're ready for standing, too.
How high do I put my
hold in your armpit? Use that armpit to hold and hold you still. Good. That's
I like that one a lot. That was really fun.
Pull up.
Then once you put your hips in,
yeah. Perfect. Good.
Just like lift it off.
And then you want to lift your
bring
your
hands down.
Yes.
Good.
Squeeze it. The chest out of your shoulder. Okay, good. Nice.
Thank you.
You had it a second ago. So the next level, for those of you who feel successful on this one, the next level is feet out in front. Your hip is pushing the pole, your tummy, your abs are all pushing the pole, you're wrapping around the pole, and you're going to tilt back, you're going to hook that left ankle, let your head go upside down, right foot goes behind, and you're a little higher off the floor. So be ready to tuck your chin to your chest, let your hands slide, land on your shoulder, legs down with control, no flopping out of it.
So you literally just kick up your left leg.
You don't kick, you use your core and pull your legs up. Yeah, but it's your left leg is the one that's going to lead. Nice. Yep. Exactly, beautiful, there we got it, yay, good. Go back to the floor, go back to the seated one.
What do I do now?
Perfect, just slide down, chin to chest and slide down. Nice.
I like you.
Back to the floor. So we need to make sure you put it on the floor before you move to the next level. Beautiful, because of how it looks. So same thing, wrap. Pull in your armpit. Okay, so the other one, that's going to help us, that's going to take you seated in the heart.
Yeah.
Can
I get more alpha?
Sure.
Can't get up there.
Got it. And you had it fine on the floor, so I think it's more of a mental thing. Really let your shoulders drop back.
Okay.
And if you want to go, if you do it one more time and you can't get it standing, then I want you to go back to the floor so you have the muscle memory of success, not the muscle memory of not quite getting it.
So it's like here.
Exactly. Tilt back. Push up and hook that left ankle.
Or you tilt back first?
No, you tilt back at the same time. So
okay.
You're going to pivot. Okay. Keep those legs on the pole, extend them up the pole. Nice, beautiful. And I'm going to show you how to face the pole with her really quick. You're going to let go of this top hand.
Hang on.
You're going to grab under the elbow of the other hand. And now this hand can let go. And you're going to come around and face the pole. Okay. Both hands towards the floor and handstand. Both hands on the floor. Other hand on the floor. Good, nice.
Am I good?
And walk your hands away from the pole.
The floor is fine.
Keep walking. Push this foot into the pole so you can get your hips off the pole. The other foot goes the other way. So this foot's going to go that way. Mm-hmm. Good, keep walking. Good, and slide down. This foot, touch the floor, put this foot on the floor.
There you go.
Nice, you got it. Yay!
So did that look good? But did it look good?
Your first time, you can watch the video. Your first time is always a struggle.
I'm too scared to like make myself go back far enough. My body is like
your body.
Good. Both hands towards the floor and handstand. And slide one leg down and just control. Let go a little bit. Yep, and walk your hands away from the pole. Push this foot into the pole so you can get your hips off the pole a bit. Good, you're good. Keep walking and then eventually this foot will touch. Nice. Beautiful. That looks beautiful. Good. Very nice. Beautiful. Other hand high, so your outside hand, just like she has her, you had it right, she doesn't have it right. Switch your hands, outside hand high. Good. I want you to do it from the floor. I want to see it. I'm so sorry. Safety first. Yeah, and that's why I want you to do it from the floor so that you're gonna slide straight down. So see it, getting close, wrap this, perfect, not too high. Perfect, right by your head. Good, and then wrap this, have your arm getting there helping you sit. Now hips out in front. Good, left ankle's gonna hook on the pole. Nice, yes, you totally did it. This knee's gonna come to this side of the pole, so you get a good hold and your hips are in, beautiful. And you can get chin to chest, nice. Let your hands slide. Beautiful, good, and legs down with control. So as your hands slide, those don't totally let go with those legs.
Okay.
Remember that they need to grab it as soon as the hands get out of the way. Okay, so you can try it standing, and I'll spot you. And I'll come and do spot you in just a sec. Beautiful, so top hand, and then bottom hand, good, and then swan dive to the floor. Hands towards the floor, because if you slide too fast, then your hands are going to touch you. Good. Flip your hand over.
Which one?
This one. Now this hand can let go. And hands on the floor and hands down.
Okay.
Yes, both hands.
Okay.
That's going to support your weight. Good. And then walk your hands away from the pole.
Okay.
And you might want to put your hair in a ponytail. Because
right.
In the
I cannot see.
Good. And then hands not so high. Because if you put your hands high, you've got to pull yourself up in the air. So keep them nice and low right by your head. Good. Grab them.
Stop
if you got hold of you. So you're leaning your back into the pole.
Cool.
Yeah, and back a little bit. So hands, you're still extended here. We're going to lean close. Good. Perfect. And now lift your hips up a bit. Yes, good. And this left ankle's going to hook on the pole in front of you.
My hands are
going to
be
smooth. I can grab the towel for you if you want. Left ankle hooks. I think your issue is seeing how your arm extended. We need to build some upper body strength to keep you engaged, keep those elbows bent. So you can focus on it and keep it, but it's really hard at first. Mm-hmm. Super close. And I can touch you up. One more time.
You have to get that leg up. Once you get that leg up, then you can get that.
There you go. Good.
Oh,
nice. Hips into the pole. Good. And then lengthen on the pole. Get this leg up there. Get the ankle on there. Turn those knees in. And then you're going to actually bring your knees around as much as possible. Good. Nice. Beautiful. Look at yourself in the mirror.
Yay.
And then chin to chest and slide onto the back of the shoulder. Chin to chest. Good.
How do you land after that? You just land on your back?
Like she just did?
Yeah. That's all you did.
Okay, we're going to wrap things up.
Oh, you face the pole. You turn around and face the pole.
Oh,
different.
Okay.
Yeah.
You don't have the upper body strength.
No, you got it!
Okay. Good.
Squeeze it. Squeeze it with your arms. Squeeze it.
And just left leg's in the hook. And we do this
on
both sides. Really let your upper body go back. We do this on both sides, so we only got through one side, but normally I switch us to the other side.
Oh! The arm hit. She was trying to just use her.
Thank you for catching that.
Go!
Good, nice.
From here, anything out.
Back side.
You just have to get the door.
So bend both knees and and wrap a little bit more. Okay, I'm moving my knee so they're not supporting you anymore. Good. Good. Yeah. I'm gonna walk away.
First, like up here.
Oh, good. Yay.
You're awesome.
And then chin to chest. Perfect. Yay. Good
Awesome.
Okay, the most important thing after working out is to stretch. So we want to make sure we lengthen our muscles after working them so hard. So come behind your pole, let's start stretching.